Greetings, I, the War Owl, greets you, and welcome back to Matchmaking Academy! It's been a while. The show where you are the star, for all the wrong reasons, but don't worry, Professor Emeritus of Counter-Strike, Dr. Warren Fowler, is now open for office hours. Our hero today is Burn Doge. He's a DMG player, Dutch here, and his favorite fish is smoked salmon. A fine choice. He had a question that I'm sure many of you guys can relate to. He throws his smokes and flashes, calls the bombsite take, starts to push into the bombsite take, and hang on a minute, aren't we supposed to do something here? Ah, crap, the smoke tutorials I watched didn't cover this. Oh, maybe I'll just dry peek this offer. Oh my gosh, what a noob! Oh man, I haven't done that in a while. Years. Feels good, man. Feels good to mock you. I want to help you think like a better Counter-Strike player. So we're going to go through this step by step and talk about how you could have improved in terms of your decision-making process. You had two players top mid, and you had three players outside A. I noticed you very quickly decided that you were going to do an A execute. And I noticed you very quickly decided that you were going to throw this CT smoke. I have to stop and ask you, why did you throw the CT smoke? Everything you do in Counter-Strike, every decision that you make, should have a reason behind it, even if it's a subconscious reason. Otherwise, you're basically button spamming. You're basically mashing buttons in a fighting game. Hey look, your smoke had a big gap in it too. So you wasted all of your utility in the first 20 seconds of the round just willy-nilly throwing it around. The first bit of intel that your team gets happens in the first few seconds of the round. An AWP player shoots through the smoke at window. The first thing that should happen is your teammates playing top mid should say, AWP window. It's very important information to know where an AWPer is inside of Counter-Strike so that you don't end up dry peeking them. You know how to deal with that position a little bit better. The two players top mid also got a lot of really good intel that you could see on your radar. There was a player in window, there was a player connector, and there was a player short. What they didn't know, or what they may not have known, is there were actually two players connector and one pushing up top mid. So you had four players at middle. That is a great opportunity to push into this bomb site, to fall back and go B. It's a great opportunity to make something happen because you know that players have pulled off of A site. I think it would have made a lot more sense to throw that smoke connector, and that works really well with the stair smoke. It blocks those players off and it allows you to push into the site and clear everything. I'm the bad guy. Look how quickly it is for me to rotate over here, and then boom, I prevent everything from this site from happening. If you had thrown this smoke right here, look at what it looks like for me now. I don't really have a lot of options at this point, do I? I could stand here, try to see somebody over the top of this smoke, maybe spam through here as you try to enter the site and hope I get a lucky shot. I could decide to push through this section. This is a very common thing that you have to watch out for, and a lot of smart players will actually Molotov this position because of how common it is for players to push through there. The other thing I can do is just wait for a retake. Wait for my teammates to come in here, the smokes to clear, and then we do a coordinated retake, which is good for you because then you have the bomb planted and you can kind of set up and watch it how you want. The other thing I can do is start to rotate this way and get over to CT as fast as I could. Now, if you don't have the smoke CT, this player's going to get here pretty quickly, but you have enough time to execute the bomb site take and get in a good position that you can deal with this player if he rotates over here. I'm a terrorist and I want to enter this bomb site and take it in this very, very specific circumstance that has been laid out in the Matchmaking Academy video. WarOwl, how is this going to help me in my games if this exact series of events doesn't happen in the exact same way? Oh, by the way, I like to throw this flash right here. I look kind of like where the satellite dish is and do a standing throw as I enter. Super good because they don't see it coming. It goes through the smokes, hits the jungle, hits the connector. Oh, what was I saying? Oh yeah, how's this help me in my own games? Well, his main question was about pushing into the bombs. His main question was about what to do after the smokes have gone down, after you've thrown your flashes and it's time to take the bomb site. I think what happened is they got scared. I think it was a Molotov down there. They walked up, I guess the bomb site take is canceled, guys. The worst thing you can do in Counter-Strike is to have your whole team run up to a site. Something happens that's unexpected, so you all just freeze and you all just stop. It gives the enemy team a lot of time to react. You need to be the one reacting here. You need to be the one pushing into this bomb site. This is the fun part, man. This is the part where the adrenaline gets going. It's time to shoot some people. It's time to murderize, baby. So as you're taking this site, The only angle you really have to worry about is right there, right? Somebody pushing through that smoke. Somebody could just stay here, hold CT, and then also watch that. You could have one guy run into the site, checking these angles, ignoring the rest of the map. You could have another guy clear sandwich, move over to help this guy. Then it's time you can plant this bomb. I'm just like thinking off the top of my head. It takes experience as you're learning to like know where all the spots are. CTs will sometimes wait here. You'll start to plant and it'll go, bah, ha, gotcha. So you have to, every Molotov you have, by the way, is a way to nullify an entire position. Molotovs are super important for taking this bomb site. But yeah, you gotta get aggressive with it, push in there. And if you go down, make sure there's a teammate there to trade. If you're the one playing further behind and you have a teammate who's entering, make sure that when he goes down, you push in and take that other player down. Now, if you get two players here, this is smoked off still. It's gonna start to clear soon. That's not smoked. You can have a player hold this for the rotate of the AWP player if it happens. One player plant the bomb. Now we got a bomb plant, now we play after plan. I'm not gonna talk about after plan, we're talking about bomb plant, right? We're talking about taking the site, which is about clearing it, killing players, and getting that bomb planted. The other place, if you go really quickly, the other place you can plant is right here. Now this is great if you have players over at middle and top mid or underpass, which they did. Now if that happens, the CTs work on taking this site. You can actually have players work on taking mid, and then they can play this bomb from this position. Now these are all things you have to think about as you're pushing in, right? You have to be like, all right, those smokes are down. This is a good opportunity to plant right here. And they also have to think like they can start spamming through the smokes if somebody tries to plant here. So maybe doing it with a flash that comes out. All this stuff goes through. You know what would help? I think it would help if we actually watch some professionals play, and I can show you exactly what I'm talking about. This is Wendigo G Money versus No Closer 69er from whatever tournament or whatever. Now watch this. They do exactly what I've been talking about with you. I went through, this was played like yesterday. I just clicked on the first one because this is such common stuff. This will happen in every game, right? So watch this. He pushes out, blocker's entering. This is playing like kind of the position you were playing. Blocker gets the entry, trades into Michaelele, perfect position. Now it's like, all right, smokes are down. See those smokes we talked about? There's the Molotov we talked about. Gonna watch for CT. There is a player there. Oh, hello there. That was a sick shot. See, he was watching so that his player could get the bomb down. Why didn't we start with this? All we had to do was watch like this 30 seconds of gameplay and you're like, oh, I understand now. This is how you Counter-Strike. Completely different round, exact same thing. We're gonna watch it from, hey look, that's the nade you threw. That's the same nade, but look, he ran through, even though there is a Molotov behind him, by the way. He ran through the Molotov as it was going off. Blocker! Just do that. Don't you know how to play Counter-Strike? You just run in there and shoot them all. With competence comes confidence. The more you work on your own game, the more you learn about Counter-Strike, the more confidence you'll have in your decisions. I'm reminded of an ancient Russian proverb that's been passed down in my family for generations and generations. I'll try to loosely translate it to English. It goes, "Rushby, do not stop." Better translated, "Better to make a mistake and learn than never act at all." Or, "Better to have loved and lost than never loved at all." That's actually Tennyson, but I wanted to make the joke. Enough talk, let's get an owl vision! Thanks to Burn Doge for sending in the demo. It takes a lot of guts to show your mistakes to the world. I'm the WarOwl and I still have no closer. How'd it go? Should I make more? Should I delete my channel? Let me know in the comments. Oh, instructions in the description on how to submit a demo, but we already got like 100 of them, so good luck.